There you go. That's
the photographer.
Hey everybody, welcome to the tip of the bird. Cheers everybody.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Tip of the bird.
Tip of
hey
the
guys.
Bird.
Thank you so much. Yeah. Welcome. we grew up loving white people. It's true, right? Because
we're under
Spanish
America,
Spanish and American, so they put in our minds that white is beautiful and brown is not.
Isn't that funny? It's funny how in the Philippines, in contrast to the United States, in the United States there's a tanning bed in every gym, right. So everybody wants to be as tan as possible. If anything, they wish they could be a darker shade than what they are. But in the Philippines,
everybody uses an umbrella while walking.
And they have whitening soap.
I've never
seen that before. Whitening soap?
Yeah.
I mean, in the Philippines, do they actually tan in the beaches? Or do they not tan?
They're wearing clothes.
See, here we actually have, in America, in the United States, we actually have tanning oil products.
To make you darker.
Like, literally, it's a funny contrast that way.
Yeah, I guess it's a... grass is greener on the other side issue. You know, even with black people, they want straight hair.
Yeah, and then white people curl their hair.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
that's a colonial mentality.
Yeah.
We always want to be way back. I'm talking about way back during the time of American colonization in the Philippines for 100 years. Some people, since our color is brown, we, some girls and guys, wanted to be white people too. That's why when they go to the beach, they have umbrella. they're wearing long sleeves.
I see them here in the United States, them doing that. I sometimes see it here.
You don't want to get darker.
Yeah, when they swim, they don't wear bathing suits or swimsuits. Yeah.
They
shorts,
like
and yeah, shorts and t-shirts. All of them shorts and t-shirts.
That kind of sucks. Is that more? Is it, so? That's more of.
That's the majority.
So that's not them being conservative. Then it's more of them protecting their skin.
No. They're being conservative.
Oh, they're being conservative. Yeah. So you're saying it's more conservative in the Philippines than it is in the United States?
Oh yeah, of course.
Really?
It's because we're religious. We're
so
Catholic.
what's like? What do you mean by conservative though? Like conservative in what way?
They don't want to wear. They don't want to wear.
Women are not
two-piece. Two-piece. Most of them don't want to wear two-piece.
Oh, they don't show skin.
Yeah.
Oh.
If you see one in the
usually
beach?
It's only shorts and a t-shirt.
Shirt and t-shirt.
Yeah.
Some people wear one-piece. Well, but with shorts.
There are some. A modern way of living, like.
But still, people will still look over the sluts. Look at these guys.
Yes. Yeah. But you know, the guys should always think it in a wrong way.
Mm-hmm.
So if they're wearing like two piece, the women wearing two piece, they start saying, oh, these women are all or something, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Filipino ladies versus American ladies.
Oh, shit. Okay.
There it is. Out on the table.
That's my favorite.
What do you think?
Okay. Who's your...
I have a very clear winner for me.
Okay.
Very clear.
Who's your Filipina. The one you just said.
Oh, no.
Filipina.
I'm not going to say what my preference is, but there is a Filipina that I just found lately. Shout out Will Desovich. What's his name?
Will Desovich.
Thank you for showing me Carla Humphries. I'm just saying, I think we can get to
he's in love with Carla Humphries.
No, I just want to, I don't know if I want to be so vulnerable yet, Carla, but I just want to get to know you. And,
if
you know
if you're
I mean?
Single, if you're single. How old is she? Probably your age, probably you're younger.
Yeah. She looks...
Okay, so you have a match for that? Carla Humphries. She's good for the
Humphrey. Okay, I have one. This might be a...
She's half built.
It's good for... good, very good for me, but some people might disagree. Anne Hathaway. She's... from childhood to now, I'm... amazed. What do you think?
No, you know what? I agree with that. I can say that because when Anne Hathaway was in Princess Diaries, dude. That's when I was like, what?
I think that was the moment, actually.
Yeah.
That was the moment where I was like, whoa.
Yeah, no.
But compared to Carla,
probably because she's fresh, she's new. Because what I was gonna say is, I see her a lot, so I kinda, you know.
Who?
I see her a lot.
Anne Hathaway.
So, you know, you kinda get used to.
Oh, you're desensitized to it?
Yeah. We have an expression in the Philippines like, you get sawa ka sa mukha. Like, you get tired of seeing the face. If you're sick of the face or something? But unlike some beautiful women, anytime you look at her, you're like, wow, it's beautiful.
No, for me, Kvijodra, honestly, it was one of your videos, Will Dasovich, that her personality was so glowing. You know what I mean?
Carla Humphries.
Oh, her personality was so glowing, nice, yeah. Was so bubbly, it was kind of magnetic.
Wow.
It was magnetic.
But you know what? That's not a good...
I sense a connection.
That's not a good example.
You don't know who I am, though, so it's okay.
Not yet?
Who's the Oprah of the Philippines? I forgot her name. She always is interviewing people. The Oprah of the
Chris
Philippines.
Chris Aquino?
Yeah, Chris Aquino. Isn't she the Oprah of the Philippines?
Oh, Chris Aquino. Yeah.
Isn't she the Oprah of the Philippines?
She used to.
Oh, she used to be?
But no.
Her title is Queen of All Media.
Yeah, but Chris Aquino.
So she's sick with autoimmune disease. Like a bunch of autoimmune
diseases. She lost a lot of weight. That kind of diseases.
So you know what? I could say Chris Aquino, beautiful.
I used to think she was really pretty too.
And she was, yeah.
Yeah. I was like, well, who's that lady?
I'm sorry about...
Oh, yeah.
About Chris. She's sick right now. She's pretty sick.
I mean, don't...
She's very serious.
No, prayers out to you, Chris Aquino, honestly. Some in the Philippines.
The same thing too.
They like tall, dark, and handsome.
Tall, dark, and handsome too. Just sometimes tall, dark, and never mind, you know.
Is that true, Carla?
is that true,
comment
Carla?
Comment below. Is that true, Carla?
Who's Carla?
Carla Humphries.
Who's she?
He's in love.
No, I don't want to say I'm in love because I still need to get to know you.
There's no need to.
For me, it's about...
You can see.
Yeah, no. Obviously, there's an
obvious... He saw her just recently and you fell in love. Carla Humphries, you remember her?
Does she have a...
Am I blushing?
Does she have an Asian blood?
She's a Filipino actress. Yeah. Carla Humphries.
She's famous. Kvijodra said she's famous in the Philippines.
She speaks enough.
I don't see her anymore, but...
Did you see her?
Yeah, on YouTube.
Oh, only on YouTube.
Yeah, sorry.
I thought you... You're ready,
Italian-American father, American born. 34 years old.
Who cares?
She's 34.
She's older than me.
Oh, no, okay. Carla. No. You don't pass the test.
No. I'm saying, like, maybe Carla wouldn't want to get to know somebody that's younger than her. I don't know. I can't speak for you, Carla, and I wouldn't want to either.
Me, my childhood crush until now, Alice Dixon. I know you're like in your 50s now. look at Alice Dixon. She's half one. She's half two. But ever since I saw her when I was a kid, up until now.
Is she Filipino?
Half two, yeah. She's popular. Alice Dixon.
It's like a mestiza.
Alice Dixon.
The mestiza is like half Filipino, half white.
And then Kring Kring Gonzalez. Up until Kring, now.
Kring, yeah.
Oh my gosh, I'm in love. Alice Dixon.
Wow.
Oh, the one that always want to hang around with the rich people. Super rich people. The Four Sisters.
Kardashian?
No. They're just like a sort of Kardashian in the Philippines.
Barreto!
They're Spanish.
Gretchen.
They are really pretty.
Gretchen.
They're
Gretchen, the Barreto Sisters.
Their blood is like a sort
Spanish.
Spanish. From Spain.
So they're like the Kardashians of Filipinos. They're socialites, actresses. That's it, that's all they do, right? And then they're famous for being famous. They hang around with the billionaire. Okay, do you have an answer for Alice Dixon? I haven't been giving a good... I don't even remember.
Oh, I like Alice Dixon.
I like Alice.
Thumbs up, Alice Dixon.
Very pretty.
What does she look like?
She's old? How old is she?
50.
Maybe that was an older picture that I showed you. What
kind of movie
is
that? Are you even there when she's older? She's gorgeous.
Alice Dixon, let's leave our spouses.
Oh, she's gone. I did. When I left Philippines, maybe there's a time that...
You, me, and Cristina Gonzalez will have a three-way.
I don't know her.
Is that a scandalous question, Cuyo? Is that common amongst Filipinas?
To be what?
Three ways? Three something?
That's unthinkable.
Is that unthinkable?
That's why I'm surprised when Isabel Daza, he said.
Yeah, Isabel Daza.
Will Dasovich, that's his title.
Yeah, he titled it. What do you think about three?
Yeah, he's being sensational.
No, but Isabel Daza, she said that she started a podcast that centered around sex. And she said that it's one of the first podcasts in the Philippines.
The Daza.
Gloria Diaz's daughter. Miss Universe! Her mom is Miss Universe!
Yeah.
Our first Filipina Miss Universe, 1969.
No, the second. Second.
No, she's the first one, Gloria Diaz.
Second.
She's the first.
Second.
I know that the second one is...
Moran is the first one.
Second one. Losers to do what?
Moran is the first one.
Gloria Diaz. I know that it's in.
No, but she's already the second.
They show it on TV every time. Please, Gloria Diaz.
She's already the second. For sure.
First Filipina Miss Universe.
No. Okay. No.
But anyway.
Yeah. You love her.
No.
Yeah. Pinakamagandang hayop sa balat ng lupa. That's the first movie.
That's her movie.
Okay, you guys gonna bet?
Yeah.
Yes.
What are you gonna bet?
Bet. Okay, ready, tip of the bird bet?
Yeah.
$100.
$100? Mm. Are you sure?
Are you sure?
Are you sure? Just make it
to... You have to shake
wait.
Make it 200.
I am the authority in Philippine showbiz.
We have the answer here, guys. We have the answer here.
Oh shit, I'm gonna buy 4 ounces.
Now Papa's scared. Are you scared now? Are you worried now?
Ask me anything about Philippine showbiz. Up until now.
No.
Are you ready?
What'd you bet?
Margie Moran, that's
it. Margie Moran first.
Do you want me to tell you? Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The first Filipina Miss Universe is...
Gloria Diaz!
Gloria Diaz!
Who's the second?
I don't know.
Margie Moran. Who's the second?
I know that.
Margie Moran. Miss Universe of the Philippines.
I did look. First Filipina Miss Universe.
Yeah.
Gloria Diaz, 1969. Did you say
1969? Because they show it on TV every time she gets... Oh, first Miss Universe. For how many years now? I've been watching her for like 30, 40.
Wait, who's your daughter?
Isabel Daza.
Isabel Daza, yeah. Isabel Daza, would you like to have us on your podcast? Maybe we can give a guy's point of view.
It's Isabel Daza.
You know the next one?
What?
Margie Moran.
Yeah. Margie Moran, right?
Yeah.
And then the third one is...
Already in the 90s.
It's Akituk.
Weird name.
Say it.
Pia Wurtzbach.
Wurtzbach.
Oh, she's the third one?
Yeah.
And then the fourth one. Then the fourth one.
That's the weird, yeah. Katriana Gray.
Gray, yeah. She's half American.
Yeah, they all mix.
And then the fifth one.
That's it, one more.
No, there's one more.
2018 is
last one. So see my point now? The standard of Philippine beauty. Nobody wins if you're brown.
A lot of countries never win. A lot of countries until now, in the history of Miss Universe, they only have the second runner-up. Mm-hmm. Some of the
India
countries,
has a lot.
Yeah.
India has a
Venezuela,
lot.
India.
I don't think they.
Brazil,
we are more than.
I like my woman brown. Brown and
you
dark,
don't like
dark
the,
black.
But. You prefer more Antoine, right?
Antoine?
I bet.
The darker the berry. The darker the berry.
The sweeter the juice.
Stay the blacker the better, the sweeter the juice. I can
Keep up the berg.
Alright guys, thanks for tuning in again to another episode. I hope you guys enjoyed our insight of USA versus Philippines. We'll catch you guys next week.
And if you did enjoy, please comment, like, subscribe, click the notification bell.
And
comment.
Let us know your true thoughts. Speak your mind in the comments.
Yes, please comment.
Whether you agree, disagree, have another point of view, we want to hear it. Maybe you can enlighten us a little bit.
Yeah, or tell us ways that we can better our blog.
Yeah, what would you want to see next? What would you like to... What would our next topic be?
Kita tayo ulit, pare!
Yeah.
Kita tayo ulit!